Christmas gifts with thanksgiving in your hearts. Enter his courts with praise. Enter his gates with thanksgiving in your hearts, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad, he has made me glad. Jesus has made me glad. Enter his gates with thanksgiving in your hearts, for he has made me glad.
Today's Mass is being sponsored by For the Soul of Pauline Rodriguez on the 2nd Death Anniversary, Month's Mind Prayer to Janet Yuan Sequeira by family members, Mass Flowers, Month's Mind Prayers to Janet Yuan Sequeira by Megan, Aryan and Kate, For the Soul of Mr. Sebastian Maria Das by Rita Anand. Mass contributions, Thanksgiving on the 80th birthday of Mrs. Mary Christina Das by Mr. Harris Posse and family. For the special blessings on the birthday of Maria Lincoln by Abraham Lincoln, JTC. On the 4th day, remembrance of Dennis Jonas by Francis Esudas. Mass intentions, Thanksgiving for the blessings received in the family by Miriam. Thanksgiving on the birthday of Anela Rosario by Anela Rosario. Thanksgiving for the blessings received in the family by Miriam. For the special intentions and peace in the family by Maria Sangeeta William. For the soul of Harry Rosario by Ansel Harshita Rosario and Mary Vasanti. On the 9th day, of the soul of Sister Elizabeth Chaurappa by Prasan Niketan Community. For the soul of Sister Elizabeth Chaurappa by St. Joseph's Convent and from Fraser Town. For the soul of Sister Jacob Lobo by Sister Lena Lobo. For the soul of Dennis Jonas by Francis Esudas. For the soul of Janet Yuan Sequeira by Adrian Rosario and family, Cleve Rosario and family, Andy Rosario and family, Anela Rosario and family, and Agnes Rosario and Gerard Sequeira. For the soul of Nana Yuan by Megan, Aryan and Kate. For the soul of Mr. Olive Dias on the 5th year remembrance by Lona Xavier family members. For the soul of Christopher Rosario, Ashley Rosario and Veronica Rosario by Anela Rosario and family. For the soul of Mr. Francis Xavier and Mrs. Isabella Rani Xavier by Aurelina Sitara. For the soul of Sister Elizabeth Chaurappa by St. Joseph's Convent, Fraser Town. For the soul of Sister Jacob Lobo by Sister Lena Lobo.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, let us thank the Lord for bringing us towards this altar. Lord has done great and marvelous works in our lives. Only thing is, we need to recognize it. Good many times we don't count the blessings of the Lord. Every day is a miracle for us. Only thing is, we need to recognize it, understand it, and be thankful. Let us feel sorry for those moments where we have not been thankful to the Lord. And today's gospel, we see there are these people who are not thankful. In spite of miracles that happened, in spite of the danger that were removed by Jesus, they did not want Jesus to stay in their place. They wanted him to go away from their place. They were not thankful to the Lord. Good many times we have been in these situations where we have not been thankful, where we did not recognize the miracles that the Lord has worked in our life. Let us feel sorry for those moments. Ask the Lord for forgiveness and mercy.
I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done
and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault,
therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of Virgin, all the angels and saints,
and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Christ have mercy. Christ have mercy. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Abraham was 100 years old when his son Isaac was born to him. And the child grew and was weaned. And Abraham made a great feast on the day that Isaac was weaned. But Sarah saw the son of Hagar, the Egyptian, whom she had bore to Abraham, laughing. So she said to Abraham, "Cast out this slave woman with her son, for the son of this slave woman shall not be here with my son Isaac." And the thing was very displeasing to Abraham on account of his son. But God said to Abraham, "Be not displeased because of the boy and because of your slave woman. Whatever Sarah says to you, do as she tells you. For through Isaac shall your offspring be named. And I will make a nation of the son of the slave woman also, because he is your offspring." So Abraham rose early in the morning and took the bread and a skin of water and gave it to Hagar, put it on her shoulder along with the child, and sent her away. And she was departed and wandered in the wilderness of Beersheba. When the water in the skin was gone, she put the child under one of the bushes. Then she went and sat down opposite him a good way off, about the distance of a bow shot. For she said, "Let me not look on the death of the child." And she was sat opposite him, she lifted up her voice and wept. And God heard the voice of the boy. And the angel of God called to Hagar from heaven and said to her, "What troubles you, Hagar? Fear not, for God has heard the voice of the boy where he is. Up, lift up the boy, and hold him fast with your hand, for I will make him into a great nation." Then God opened her eyes, and she saw a well of water. And she went and filled the skin with water and gave the boy a drink. And God was with the boy, and he grew up. He lived in the wilderness and became an expert with the bow. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
The lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
The lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
This lowly one called, the Lord heard, and rescued him from all his distress. The angel of the Lord is encamped around those who fear him to rescue them.
The lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
Fear the Lord, you his holy ones. They lack nothing, those who fear him. The rich suffer, want, and go hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no blessing.
The lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
Come, children, and hear me, that I may teach you the fear of the Lord. Who is that desires life and longs to see prosperous days?
The lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Of his own will he brought us forth by the words of truth, that we should be a kind of first fruits of his creatures.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, when Jesus came to the other side of the sea, to the country of Gadarenes, two demon-possessed men met him, coming out of the tombs, so fierce that no one could pass that way. And behold, they cried out, "What have you to do with us, O Son of God? Have you come here to torment us before the appointed time?" Now, a herd of many pigs was feeding at some distance from them. And the demons begged him, saying, "If you cast us out, send us away into the herd of pigs." And he said to them, "Go." So they came out and went into the pigs, and behold, the whole herd rushed down the steep bank into the sea and drowned in the waters. The herdsmen fled, and going into the city, they told everything, especially what had happened to the demon-possessed men. And behold, all the city came out to meet Jesus, and they saw him, they begged him to leave their region. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our God is a God of love who takes initiative to extend his relationship with all of us. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, according to teleological understanding, we see that every human being is born with a purpose to fulfill. What is the purpose of our life? God has created everyone in his own image and likeness, which means we share in the essence of God, and because of which we are called to partake in the covenantal relationship with God. And because of this covenantal relationship, we are invited to experience God, to recognize God, so as to give him glory, honor, praise, and worship, which is his due. My dear friends, in today's first reading, we just now heard that Sarah wanted to drive out Hagar and Ishmael so that they may not share in the inheritance of Abraham.
But God's ways are so different that He invites, He promises Abraham that He will bless Ishmael and make him a great nation because he fulfilled the purpose to which he is called. And Ishmael, being the son of slave woman Agar, he experienced the blessings of God, and because of his faithfulness, he becomes a great nation. In today's gospel also, we see that Jesus takes an initiative to cure those two men who were possessed by demons. But what had happened was a total contradiction. And I want to highlight two elements here. The first one, the reaction of the demons. As soon as Jesus came closer to the two men, the demon shouts, "What have you to do with us, O Son of God?" By pointing out, they predict Jesus' passion and death and resurrection. They were able to recognize Jesus Christ as a Son of God, a true living God. And the divinity was expressed by those two demons. And we also see that Jesus Christ comes out and he cures those two men and shows his authority over demons. By pointing out appointed time, those demons depict that Jesus is going to experience this passion, death and resurrection, after which he is going to come and judge the living and the dead. This incident has got a parallel with Matthew chapter 16, verse 22, wherein Jesus foretells about his death and resurrection, but Peter rebuked, saying, "Lord, that should never happen to you." But Jesus, the immediate response of Jesus, we can understand, "Satan, get behind me." That's how, my dear friends, whenever we try to establish, whenever we have to cultivate the kingdom values, there is an obstacle from demon. But today, the story doesn't end there. Jesus, who conquered victory over death, comes out victoriously by driving out demons from those two men. Yes, the second important point that I want to mention is that the reaction of the people. The immediate reaction of the people was pleading Jesus to leave the village. It is those people who experienced God's love through Jesus' preaching, through Jesus' teaching, and the healing ministry of Jesus Christ. But what happened is totally a different scenario. Because it is those who experienced Jesus Christ so close, they come out saying, "Jesus, kindly leave the village." Because for them, the material well-being was so much more important than the spiritual wealth which has to be possessed by their life. By introspecting into our life, let us analyze our life. In the beginning, as I said, the material well-being becomes a more important aspect to all of us, wherein the spiritual aspect which is to be given by Jesus Christ, we forget in our life. What is the option that we choose? Eucharist is where we encounter God face to face and receive Him into our hearts through the liturgy of the word and through the valid reception of the Holy Communion. How we are able to recognize the Son of God in our daily Eucharistic celebration? God is ever loving and He cares us so much that He extends His love to all of us. How far we are able to understand, even though we are sinful, unworthy, God is able to extend His love. How far we are able to respond to this call? If we have failed to recognize God's love in us, let us pray during this Holy Eucharistic celebration and make a firm decision that we will experience God's love and discern the will of God in our life so as to experience God's love and share that love to our family members, to our friends, and in everything that we do, so as to give Him glory, honor, praise, and worship, which is His due. That becomes and that fulfills our purpose in life. Amen.
Lord, accept this bread and wine. take our hearts and make them thine. Take our work and our anxiety. Give us life and liberty. Change this bread into your body, and this wine into your blood. Change our lives, make us united, Lord, to spread the love of Christ the Lord. Lord, accept this bread and wine. Take our hearts and make them thine. Take our work and our anxiety. Give us life and liberty.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of mine and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, hosanna, hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying,
Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Peter our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to the apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
grant us peace.
This is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away our sins. Happy are we who are called to the banquet of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual Communion Prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, please come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you now as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Prayer to Saint Joseph. Hail, guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To you God entrusted his only Son. In you Mary placed her trust. With you Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too. Show yourself a father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen.
The Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may hear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
And may the blessings of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen. Thanks be to God. Thanks do I give to the Lord with my whole heart evermore. Thanks do I give to the Lord for his faithfulness and love.
In the presence of the angels I will bless him and adore him before his holy temple. On the days I call the answer, he increased the strength of my soul. Thanks do I give to the Lord with my whole heart evermore. Thanks do I give to the Lord for his faithfulness and